Let's start. So in this video we will be studying the steady flow energy equation for open system. So in this video I will let you know the applications of the steady flow energy equation. Also we will be discussing some important things that you have to remember for solving these problems under this topic. So this is the equation that we have derived for steady flow energy equation. So always remember this equation for solving problems, so it will be helpful for you. So always remember this equation as it is. So you want to substitute the enthalpy value in this equation only in kilojoule per kg. இந்த ஈக்குவேஷன் எப்பவுமே ஞாபகம் வச்சுக்கோங்க, இதுதான் வந்து ஸ்டெடி ஃப்ளோ எனர்ஜி ஈக்குவேஷன் ஃபார் ஓப்பன் சிஸ்டம். க்வெஸ்சனில் அந்த மாதிரி கேட்டிருந்தா இந்த ஈக்குவேஷன் தான் யூஸ் பண்ணணும். இந்த டிவைட் பை 2000 டிவைட் பை 1000 இதெல்லாம் கொஞ்சம் கேர்ஃபுல்லாக பார்த்துங்க. இதெல்லாம் அப்படியே மனப்பணம் பண்ணி வச்சுக்கோங்க. இந்த ஈக்குவேஷனை சிம்பிள் தான், எனர்ஜி கம்மிங் இன் வந்து கியூவும் மாசம், எனர்ஜி கோயிங் அவுட் வந்து ஒர்க்கு, வெளியே போகிறது வந்து ஒர்க்காக போகுது. அப்படி வச்சு ஞாபகம் வச்சுக்கலாம், உனப்பணம் தேவையில்லை. ஸோ என்தால்பியோட வேல்யூ வந்து கிலோ ஜூலில் தான் போடணும், ஜூலில் போடவே கூடாது இந்த ஈக்குவேஷனில். நான் அப்படி தான் இப்போ இந்த ஈக்குவேஷன் நம்ம செட் பண்ணி வச்சுருக்கோம். ஜூலில் தான் போடணும், ஜூலில் போட்டால் உங்களுக்கு ஹீட்டோட வேல்யூ ஒர்க்கோட வேல்யூ வந்து உங்களுக்கு கிடைக்கிறது வந்து கிலோ ஜூலில் கிடைக்கும். So we have to put the enthalpy value in kilojoule per kg only, and we should not put it in joule per kg, so that you will be getting the answers for heat and work in kilojoule. So it will be the correct format. So just remember as it is. So now let's see the applications of steady flow energy equation. So this equation can be applied in pipeline flow, heat transfer process like that. Also we can apply it in mechanical power generation in engine. So in these areas we can apply this equation. So if there is no elevation means we should not consider this Z1 Z2 value. Similarly if elastic given means we have to consider V1, V2. If work given means we have to consider. But also if it is given as adiabatic wall means then Q will be 0, so the value of dQ will become 0. Likewise you have to change this equation according to the question. So if in the question they have not given the velocity value means then you have to just skip it and assume it to be 0. So we can apply this equation in nozzle. So for nozzle the kinetic energy will be maximum and the pressure will be minimum. So P means pressure, and so if the kinetic energy is maximum means the velocity will be maximum. So the nozzle is basically used to increase the velocity of the fluid. So at the outlet the pressure will be minimum, so the velocity at the outlet will be maximum. So this is the use for nozzle. So the diffuser is just opposite to the nozzle. Here the kinetic energy will be minimum, so it is used to reduce the velocity at the outlet. So if the velocity is reduced means the pressure will be increase. So these two are inversely proportional. Generally we will be asked for finding the velocity V2 for nozzle and diffuser. So these are the sums you will get. So for throttling process the pressure will be low, The throttling process is used to reduce the pressure, means it's an expansion. So the enthalpy will be maintained constant. So for throttling process, the H1 H2 will be equal. So also the for throttling, the kinetic energy will not change. Also remember, if it is an adiabatic one, means then you should not consider dq value, you should put 0 for dq. Adiabatic one dq on the 0 or go throttling na pressure, no change in kinetic energy. Adhe mani formula la vandu neenga substitute pannumbodhu h1 h2 vandu equal ah irukum. Neenga sum paaka paaka ungalukku purinjirum, oru oru sum paaka paaka ungalukku purinjirum. Adhe mani sign conversion no important. Turbine means it's a positive work, it is given, it is used to produce work, so it's positive. For compressor it's negative work. Also the sign conversion is also important. So you have to put the equation as it is, and you want to just substitute the given data, means then you will be getting the answers easily. So that's all about this. That's the end of this video. So please don't worry, while solving problems we will be revising this concept once again. So at that time all your doubts will be get clear. Thank you for watching.